What makes you queer?
Well, I painted my fingernails a rainbow. See here on my pinky, a dollop so dinky, but powerful, potent, and purposefully pink. Within its tiny confines, my little girl dream twinkles, to distract from all growing wrinkles. Once upon a time, you might think pink was weak, but have you not seen its profound power united? Not tickled pink, but ticked off pussy pink, and taking no more shit from the stink of anything foul. Pink is strength imparted from its corresponding tender parts. To nab something drab and transform the norm, pink. Oh, pink, queerest shade under the sun. Oh, pink, always on the brink of something fun. Pink, 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 I don't think I can squeal any more in delight than I do for you, pink. Mm. And on the other hand, reflecting time so refined, the regal and stately shade known as purple, properly placed for my dainty old lady to sip her tea in calm and comfort with a sense of high society. Not wishing any harm, just wisdom upon everyone. Well respected as reflected through the ages like the sages, dressed in various sensible shades and bountiful brocades. The perspicacity of plum, the vibrancy of violet, the exquisite ambience imbued by amethyst, or the light lift that you get as a gift from lavender. Purposely elegant and tastefully poignant purple. Now hang loose and you'll find on my hand's caboose my apprehensible and indispensable opposable green thumbs to represent the lush Eden inside of me. Both the untamed jungles of sensuous mystery within, alongside my meticulously groomed hothouse. Now, should I still be found sucking my thumb, it means I've come to enjoy the endless green pastures of delight. All manner of savory succulents and vivacious vegetation for elation. For that is how my garden grows. But it's also where my envy shows. I hope my bitter herbs aren't tossed in the mix too often. A little spice when I'm not feeling nice. For if I should bite my thumb at you, it is indeed intended as an insult. What can I say? You wouldn't like me when I'm angry. It's only natural. Green. Now watch out. Pay attention. Look here, you've been warned, but don't be too alarmed, dear fellow, that beneath the sunny disposition, warm and mellow, to be faced with a vibrant, vivid, livid, not really so timid yellow. Now I'd be lying if I said I didn't fear that you'll dismiss me as a mere lilting daffodil or dandelion queer. You can paint me a coward, yellow, but whatever might dribble down my pant leg metaphorically is merely one moment of this bold and buttery blonde, so beware. Should I release my wits upon you, you'll be showered, and certainly not in praise. Caution is required for such awesomeness acquired, accented and highlighted in the accent of yellow. And here we find ourselves at blue, among the throngs, a frequent favorite hue. Not just for baby boys, but go on, paint up your beards, and release your tension, lest I mention your balls. Sunk into a funk of a Picasso period, somber mood indigo. The weight of regrets where blue bruises forge tearful rivulets. Or fleeting moments cut off too soon. Come back, I miss you, midnight blue. Things that were never said or said with dread until all blue in the face. I want to moan, why do I feel so alone? Give me strength to embrace navy blue. Shock me into awareness, electric blue. Let me dive into the pool of a cool mid-century blue. Or let me soar once more into the vast and wild blue yonder of sky. Oh yes, give me smooth, soothing baby blue, I love you. How could I not stay true on a planet so blue? Now, how to define a color that defies to rhyme? The rash and bold does not always do what is told, orange. But do not get me started with that vile atrocity, that hypocrisy, a disgrace to the particular hue and the entire human race. But yes, orange can be gaudy and audacious, body and salacious, like daggers in the eyes of sensibility. So feisty and zesty and testing the limits of taste, tart and tangy, sweet and sultry, appropriate color for a citrus fruit and much more to boot. The chakra source of our creative and erotic self, sending vibrations to our imaginations from mild to wild. Orange ubiquitously encapsulates an entire season of autumnal splendor, from falling leaves to all hallowed eaves. So wicked when you need it to be, so gift as a pumpkin as required. Abounding and astounding, so go for it already. Orange, you're glad you did. Now at last, give in to your temptation and bite the apple red. It may be reductive, but what could be more seductive? Such a striking, stunning, cunning color, worn in all the right places and dressed to impress. Intoxicating like a fine wine, feel the rush as cheeks blush, lips drips, and bosoms blossom, popping with a rosy radiance and a cherry on top. It's so totally thrilling and simultaneously chilling. After all, cut us open, do we not bleed red? Spill too much of it, and we're dead red? Wrap us in ribbons, bandage our wounds, paint the town red. Are we seeing nothing but it red? For more than a scarlet fever has reached a ferocious fervor in our head, there's a most uncivil war of otherness overwhelming all our senses. Political fires burning, bridges burning, crosses burning, burning truth and reason. Witness the witless demise of our society. Is this what we get with Republican red, right-wing red, fascist red? No, 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 no. Fuck you, red. We are ready to serve right back at you. Red revolution, red resistance, red rage, goddamn motherfucking, if what the hell is happening, if we all But there is a calm that can be found in the palette of the palm. When the black and the white unite, we just might be all right. Making adjustments in this teeter-totter balancing act of the universe, these dancing cosmic yin and yang through time and space, combining all the colors, removing all the colors, the blending of sight and the absence of light, everything and nothing, tranquility and clarity in the realm of possibility. Reset, restore, renew, refresh, rebegin. There is so much to be said about black and white, but they speak volumes for themselves in voluptuous wavelengths of silence. As I gaze upon these fingertips, I am reminded that I possess all of this and more. A kaleidoscopic collage of colors and contradictions, and in the patchwork pattern, a most dramatic, chromatic diorama, my fingertips are bright little signposts, telltale transmissions of this is who I am, This is the queer I am here to be. And I see the prism you imprison behind yours as well. Free the full spectrum of who you are. We all contain Whitman's magnificent multitudes. I painted my fingernails a rainbow to help answer the question, what makes you queer? Thank you.